Hi. So Trello has been one of my favorite personal task management systems for many, many years. What I love about it is how much you can do on the free plan without running into functionality or sort of space issues. It does quite a lot if you're just a single user, not operating in a team and not needing all the more sort of complex and additional features that you can start to pay for at the other price points. So it's pretty easy to use, and there's a lot of help available as well because it has been around for so long. You can Google what you're looking to do, and someone probably has created a template or has some advice on how to adjust it. So while it's not my current task management tool, I have had a lot of success with it in the past. I thought I'd show you how I would set it up for personal to-dos. And I'll say here that the system that I use on Trello is meant for the things that are quite involved, and I use it side by side with a really basic the notes app on my phone, just a basic text list when it's really tiny things that I can tick off easily, like call this person or post this thing or what have you. So I kind of use these in tandem, and this is intended as the digital space, often for sort of digital life admin or sort of more complex tasks. So let me show you how I would do it. When you first log into Trello, if you've been invited to any other workspaces, you have those appearing here. You might have your own workspace, or you might be just setting up for the first time. And in this case, we're going to go ahead and create new board. You can pick one of their pre-selected backgrounds. You've got to give it a title. So this is Jess's to-do list. Choose who will be able to see it, if it's private or the whole workspace. And I'm just going to create that board now. That background image is not my favorite, so I'm going to go over here, change background. And who doesn't love going to Japan? So I always like to have it as a nice visual feast for a space that I plan to come and use. I want it to be something attractive to look at. You can expand this sidebar, which becomes, oops, a little quick selector if you've got other boards, and then you can slide it away again. They're helpfully giving me interesting little shortcuts. So here we are with the sort of default out of the box setup. They say to do, doing, and done is a good starting point, and I used to agree, but I have changed my ways in recent times. I found that as I built out this board and would have lots of things in each list, it wasn't quite specific enough to have just what I was on the backlog, tasks to do, what I was currently doing and what's been done. So there's a couple of others that I'd add in here. One is ideas to be scoped might do. And this is to represent things that ideas I've had or things that I want to capture somewhere, but I'm not committed to doing them. It's just something that I might kind of think about what would be involved and flesh it out before it kind of graduates to the to-do list. To-do itself, I separate into a couple of different sort of sub statuses. So the first one is not started. So I know I'm going to do this thing, but I haven't started. It's basically the backlog or the things that haven't been put up to sort of next in line, but I want to do one day. The next up is the things I wanted to do next, funnily enough. The doing is the same as kind of in progress. I'll just use in progress because then kind of means the same thing, but that's just what I call it. And then there's another task list that I've been using recently, which is recurring tasks, because these are the ones that come up over and over again, either weekly, monthly, yearly, whatever they are. Might be, review, home loan rate, 6 monthly, for example. And with these ones, if you just hit the D, you can change the due date. So in this case, I know it's something I like to do every 6 months, and so I might look ahead of maybe the start of spring. It's a good time. I'll say a Saturday when I'm not at my usual job. and save that. So, and then after that 6 month point has passed, I would just kick that date along to 6 months ahead. So those recurring tasks, I like to track with in the card name what the recurring cadence is, and then I'll just keep nudging them ahead instead of creating a new card. The done list does what it says. The only other one I'd add here is paused, pending. And this is when something can't be started. It's not in progress, or maybe it was in progress, but it's not now. It's waiting on someone else to do something. I can't keep doing it now. So this is my kind of default setup. I could go in here and how do I create? I think I could create a template. No, I don't know where to do that. That'll be a different video, but you could set it up so that these come pre-populated as the lists when you start a new board. I just haven't figured out how to do that right now. So to show in a bit more detail how this might work in reality, I might sort of describe how I use each list. I guess the first point is making sure that each card within a list is a task that can be completed on its own. As soon as you have related tasks, I find it most useful to have them as separate cards so that one part could be not started and the part that's in progress could be moved along. The next kind of basic task management 101, I guess, is when you have something that needs a bit more explaining, that you can use the description. So keep the card title really simple and the description to flesh it out. So what that looks like, for example, in my, let's say my not started list, one of my tasks is clear Gmail content. Old content, clear Gmail old content. And so then within that, the task here, if I was going to spell it out in more detail, it's audit old emails and attachments, delete stuff I don't need, save attachments and exported email PDFs to Dropbox. And so it gives a little bit more flavor around what this task is about, whereas in the board itself, you just get this nice, clear, quick, high-level task name. And it means you can kind of scan your list and go, oh yeah, this thing, what was that about again? And then get the detail view. Some other things, so I guess recurring tasks for me, this would include tax return yearly in July. I know that this one is something that I would really like to close off this week. So let's say something for this Wednesday. Another one, I guess, when we're talking about ideas to be scoped. So something I've thought about is illustrate a tarot card deck. So this doesn't have a due date. It's not something that's like really on my list, but it's an idea that I thought, oh, this will help hone my illustration skills. I might do this one day. Here's just somewhere to kind of capture that. Next, we might say something that's next up. Get a new headshot for LinkedIn. So my old one is driving me bananas. So here I might say, okay, I'm not going to do it this week, but I want to do it soon. Next up, it can be in a couple of weeks' time. In progress, I might say work on my ebook, write a chapter. And again, sometimes I give these a due date that just represents like the next date that I plan to spend any time on them. So now the reason I'm adding in some dates here is also to show you my favorite power-up. Power-ups are basically just extra features, and on the free plan I think you get one power-up, and the one that I like to use is the calendar view, calendar power-up. So by clicking on calendar power-up, when I have added dates to things, it helps me to see them like visually on a calendar, not connected to my Google Calendar that I use for just keeping track of events and things, but it does help me to kind of organize where I see things sitting and then notice like, oh, actually, you know, I have two things here, I better spread them out. You can move the dates around, just pick them up and drag them in here, which is super handy. The other thing that I use when I'm working in Trello is the labels. And so there are things in here like clear Gmail old content. So this would be a low energy task. And I'd call that maybe a, what's a low energy color? Green. Low energy task, digital detoxing, digital decluttering. Maybe I'll say that one's a blue label. So you can start to use labels for things, and I'll show you why in a minute. This one could be a high energy task with a high energy color like bright pink, and maybe home loan rate is, where are my labels? Up here. Could be a low energy task, and this one is about finances, which is blue feeling to me. And then as you get these kind of labels coming together, so finance, and this might be a little more high energy because you need to focus, get a new headshot for LinkedIn. This one could be probably high energy as well. I'll leave my ideas to be scoped without labels for now, but what this lets you do is you can now filter by, for some reason, I know I need to refresh to bring them up, which I don't know why. If I now filter by low energy task, I can see just the things that I tagged with low energy, and then if I untick it, I get everything back again. Or I might want to see everything relating to finances, and so that'll just bring up that subsection. Or I might want to see the high energy tasks. I'm like, hey, I've got some energy today. What's my high energy stuff? So those labels can be a really handy way to just, quickly filter the view and only see what you need. I also really like learning the shortcuts. So if you hover over a card and hit the D, that's D for date. And so in this case, it's not started. Maybe I don't need to give this one a date. I can just leave that off. Whereas this one, if I hit D for date, it says, yep, you've booked this in for the 17th of August. I'm happy with that. The other thing you can do if you are sharing a board, and if there's more than just one person, is use the M for member, and you can assign the card to a particular person. In this case, and the way that I would use it for myself, they're all me, so I don't need to assign anyone. The only difference to that, or the only time that that would actually be helpful to assign to you, even though no one else is on the board, is so you can use the all cards view. So if I add myself to those cards, then click my little avatar in the top right and cards, I get this really nice view of things across all of my boards showing all cards, and it shows me what's due in the next 7 days, due in the next month, and then due later. And so if I had multiple Trello boards in play, that view would start to build up with my tasks from across the boards, providing I had stuck my noggin on them. Maybe that's enough to go through for now. That's just the basics of how I'd set up this sort of Kanban view for my own to-do lists. And again, it does get easier to explain things and easier to understand as you build them out, which is going to be different for everyone. But this is a really nice way to get set up and get started if you haven't used Trello before. Hope this helps, and I'll see you next time. I forgot to tell you, there's a post on our blog, producingparadise.com, that goes into a lot more detail with some screenshots and steps if the video has been helpful but you're looking for a little bit more. So check that out and subscribe to our YouTube. We will love you forever. Thanks. Bye.